all the other shows all around. Yeah.
Maybe you like to sing off key, grab a stranger and dance. But when you do these things, you wear a trench coat. Your name's Francois, you're from France. Sometimes you put on a cape, a pink wig to your name, and call yourself Super Maybelline.
Bandits and engines!
Oh, oh. No!
I have to go in to ShopRite. I get my free turkey today.
Oh, yes, yes. Happy Thanksgiving.
All right, get them horses moving. We gotta get back on the trail.
Yes.
We got bandits behind us.
I know. We can make it. We can
All right,
make it.
I'm jumping out here.
All right, good luck. Good luck.
Okay, Essie. You got this. You're gonna get the job. Blackout. The game is sportscasters. Who in this room likes live sports? Any Mets fans in the house? So what I need from you is a common household activity.
Cleaning.
Dishes.
Washing dishes?
Woohoo!
Or loading the dishwasher?
Ooh, loading the dishwasher.
Loading the dishwasher! Welcome to Sportscasters!
Tonight's the night! I'm Kurt Bannerman.
And I'm Ticket Sunnyzod.
And welcome to the Good Housekeeping Tidy Up Olympics.
We're so excited to have you here tonight.
Of course. We're beautiful here in sunny California, here at the Ponce de Leon multipurpose room.
Yes, it's lovely here this time of day. The sun's coming right in.
Yes, it is. Tell us about the event we have coming up tonight.
Oh, it's very exciting. We are doing Dishwash Load a Thon.
Yes,
that's right. To raise money.
Now, Trinket, I remember when you took the gold in this event in 04 back in Carson City.
That's when it was a sport we could do in the Olympics.
Yeah, that's right, that's right.
I always enjoyed my favorite move. It was the bending over.
Yes, very good. Yes. And it looks like our competitors are making their way onto the arena.
I'm very excited about this year's event. Our competitors are going to be fabulous, just fabulous.
Yes, and we have Helga Broomhilda from Germany.
Yes. Yes, and Kristen Kutcher from Kinderhook. Yes.
Yes. Now, Helga, Helga work in a woman's prison in Dusseldorf. on the mess line.
Yes.
She's got the chops, I should
say. She is 8 years in a row the winner.
And tell us about our challenger here.
Kristen, she is just has a lot of energy. You know, she is the cattiest kindergarten teacher in her school. That's what she's known best for. Yeah. But she also loves to save cats.
Yes, that's fascinating. Well, I give her a puncher's chance today.
Yes.
And tell us, the champion is warming up here. And,
yes.
What is this move? Is there a signature move?
It is a signature move. It's called the Kindle Clock.
Yes.
And she does it when she's getting ready to load. Yes, the Kindle Clock. Ah, yes. Okay. Very good form. Very good form.
And our challenger here is warmed up too.
Yes. She uses the pointer face. The pointer face in her face is all of her energy. She puts it right into her fingers.
She's using the digital dishwasher.
Yes. And okay. We're getting ready. I think we're hearing that the band is coming.
I think we are. We have Helga and Karen and
it's gonna be a tight race.
I'm Kurt Bannerman, and they're off.
They're off. Oh, look at this form. They're doing amazing things. Now, there's a secret extra thing they have to do, which they don't know about. We're going to announce it right now.
Tell them about the secret.
They have to use vinegar from the dishwasher next to them. They have to bail it out and put it in the dishwasher use it.
That's right.
Look at the stacking technique we have from Helga. It's amazing. It's fabulous. Yes, she's doing amazing.
The challenger has quite the aerobic activity going, and this is quite a finish. It looks like it's going to go come right down to the water. And that is time. That is
time,
ladies and gentlemen. And we have this in.
Who's the winner?
Winner? It is Helga Broomhilda from Germany.
I feel very good. Back in Germany, then we make our dinner. It's sausage, lots of sausage and sauce. And so we have big mess in my house.
Well, you don't have to clean up a mess, for sure. Yes.
I have 14 and a half children.
Yes, I'm sure they're fabulous. I'm sure they're fabulous. Let's go to Kurt and see how our losing team member is doing.
Yes, I'm Kurt Vandeland here with the undisputed loser today.
Thank you.
Okay, the game is entrances and exits. Sam, Liz, and Trista will perform a scene for you. And when they hear a specific word assigned to them by you, they must immediately exit. And when they hear that word again, they must come back on. First thing I need is an activity that three people can accomplish together.
Football.
Monopoly.
Excellent. Three people play Monopoly. Now I need a word for Sam. Any word?
Banana.
Okay. Word for Liz?
Albatross.
And word for Trista?
Gorgeous.
What?
Gravitas.
Okay, so one more time.
Banana.
Albatross.
Gravitas.
Banana. Albatross.
Gravitas.
Banana. Albatross.
Gravitas.
And now entrances and exits.
I'm so glad you guys came over for Friday night board games.
Ah, Margie, I'm so happy you invited us. What else was I going to do on a Friday night in the Koi Mart?
Well, I had other things I could do with a man, but boy, he was such an albatross, I couldn't even deal with it.
Well, you know what? I think I need to go to the bathroom first.
Yeah.
Listen, this is Monopoly.
All right.
Now, I was going to bring out, Battleship, but that's for two people.
No.
And we have three people.
That's right.
Yeah.
You have all the pieces?
I have all the pieces, and I added some of my own.
Oh, what kind
of pieces? Look, this piece of fruit.
Oh, is that a banana?
Yeah, excuse me, I have to go put on my pajamas.
Alright. I want to be the banker, so I'm going to totally be the banker because I know exactly how to count. And I know how to cheat. Just like someone with a lot of gravitas, you know what I'm saying? But first, I think I need to think about my boyfriend. I hope that albatross is doing okay.
Alright, now I feel so much better.
Oh, where were you? You've gone forever.
You know,
I'm going to be the banker.
You're going to be the banker.
I'm going to be the banker.
Good, okay. So, okay, these are different pieces. She said she had pieces.
She does.
A banana?
Yes, she brought
Look,
a banana.
Look, I made chili!
Oh, my God!
I always think a good board and I need some chili.
That is some good chili.
I have a lot of gravitas.
There you go.
I have some pieces I brought. I'm going to go get them.
Okay, so, let's see. We got the board game here. We got all these different pieces.
Listen, forget the game. Now that she's out of the room. I got a problem.
What?
My husband. I stuffed him in the closet and I locked him in there. Okay. He's an albatross!
Oh, my God. I'll need to make sure it's locked.
I gotta work on my gravitas until you get back.
Oh, alright, I got my pieces. There's something weird, some sound coming from the closet. I don't know, you might want to check on it.
Don't go in the bedroom!
I was looking for the bathroom, I'm sorry.
Alright, fine. Here, have a bowl of chili.
I love chili. Did you put bananas in this chili?
I do. They make you have nice girth like an albatross.
Oh, very nice. I like bananas. Oh, shoot. I got to get out of here. Listen, while she's gone, I got to ask you. I heard something very weird in the closet. Do you know, is there something weird going on?
They're having some problems. He was kind of mean to her this morning, so, you know, once he put the beans in the chili, he went to the bathroom and she locked him in the closet.
Oh my God, he sounds like a terrible albatross.
So, are you sure those are bananas in the chili?
They are bananas. Yeah,
okay,
they are.
Just wanted to make sure.
Yeah.
So,
what kind of an albatross do you think he is?
Oh, he's a big one. Let me tell you. Let me go and check and make sure that I can maybe get him out.
I'm going to see if I can taste the bananas in this chili. It sounds very weird to me.
Listen, I think there's a problem.
What's the matter?
I think Edward's dead.
Who's your husband, Edward?
Yes, he's dead, I think. Don't say anything. Listen, she's got a thing for him, and don't think I don't know.
Really?
Oh, yeah, that's why I stuffed him in the closet.
Oh, boy. She's got a lot of nerve, that one.
Yeah, I only invited her because I wanted to see what would happen between a man in the closet and a woman.
I could totally understand. I dealt with that with my boyfriend once, but, you know, not anymore. Because, well, now that you told me that your husband is dead, I can tell you, I killed mine.
You and I, we have a lot in common.
We do.
We could start a business.
We could.
It would be a huge albatross.
It would.
But I think we could do it.
I think we could.
All right. All right, yourself.
You know?
What?
Why did you lock him in the closet? He might be dead in there.
None of your business.
Are you sure those are bananas in the chili?
I don't know. I think.
did.
I know she did.
She's bananas.
She is bananas.
I know.
My dog is dead. Why he's dead? Don't say anything about my banana chili. I'm gonna go meditate.
She's gonna meditate. Yeah, you know. Well, you know. I mean, there's such gravitas in her voice.
I know. I better go check on her. I don't want her doing anything, killing anybody else.
I don't know what's gonna happen. And look at this Monopoly board. And look at this friggin' banana piece here. What the hell? So you don't play banana. You don't play Monopoly with bananas. Oh God, one's killing her boyfriend. One's killing her husband.
It worked. Shut up.
Gone?
Yes. She is gone. He's dead. Now we can sit down and play Monopoly.
Welcome to the Critics' Choice. My name is Beezus Mulroney.
And I'm Debbie. You can just call me Debbie.
Debbie, it's so nice to see you here on our weekly show on Periscope.
I love Periscope. I've been on here for like 5 minutes and I'm already doing trainings for people.
That's wonderful. We're roommates. We live in a little apartment together.
We do.
We like to watch movies.
We do.
And then we like to talk about them and criticize them.
Yeah, we really do.
So that's what we're going to do tonight.
Yeah, we are. And we're Periscoping on it. So, you know, share with your friends. Swipe up, swipe to the left, swipe in a circle. Get all your friends on here from Twitter. It's going to be great.
I don't know what that means.
I know you don't. You just stay with me.
All right.
So, should we start with the first one?
Yes, yes. What's the first one?
Oh. This first one is called Green Sweater.
Green Sweater!
It was in a how-to kind of a genre mixed up with a romantic comedy. I thought it was fabulous.
It was wonderful. It's Woody Allen's new film.
Oh, I love Woody Allen. I had the chance to work with him when I was living in New York City.
You did?
I did. Every day he would come into the coffee place and he would order his coffee and I would work there while he waited and paid.
Well, I've heard he's discovered many people in their day jobs. Why didn't you get a job in the movie?
I don't want to talk about that. Let's talk about Green Sweater instead.
All right, this movie is about a man, a curmudgeon-y little man who lives in a house and has a green sweater.
Yes, his sweater is very green. It's like neon green.
It's bright, and it almost gives him a headache migraine.
It does, and then he goes to get the headache looked at, and he falls in love with the ER nurse.
Yes, and she is horrid.
Well, she is. She is.
It's sort of a movie about acceptance, that we're, even if we're horrid, we're lovely.
That's true. We have a scene we're going to show.
Yes, let's show a clip. This is a pivotal moment in the film.
I think it's when they first meet.
I think you're right. What do you want? Oh my God, that sweater!
The sweater's killing me. I can't.
Oh my God. There, go. Now get out of here. Let's go home.
Can I come home with you?
Sure. Let's go. See, I think that film shows a little bit of iambic pentameter.
Just a little. You know, I actually had lunch just the other day. I was eating at a coffee place, another coffee place, and I was having lunch, and I was sitting right next to the person who's the great-great-granddaughter of the guy that invented iambic pentameter.
That's really. I give this film 2 cups of coffee. What do you give
it? I give it 2 cups of coffee as well, but mine is sugar. Mine has sugar.
A little bit of sugar.
Yeah.
She likes the curmudgeon-y man.
I do, I do. Let's go to the next movie.
Oh, yes, I can't wait for this one.
Oh, this one is great. This one is called Comedy Asylum.
Oh, yes. Now, this is a twist between Cuckoo's Nest and Comedy Central.
Yes.
So you have an asylum filled with mad people.
That's right.
But they're all stand-up comedians as part of the therapy.
John Stewart had a cameo.
He did. He played the man who gave everyone injections.
That's right. I used to take the bus with John Stewart before he was on TV. Did you know that?
No, I didn't know that.
Yes, we had lots of great talks.
Are you still friends?
I don't want to talk about that. Let's talk about Comedy Asylum.
All right, let's do it.
Yes.
All right, so anyway, there's a special appearance by Kate Winslet.
Yes,
I love Kate Winslet. She's so British.
I know, yes, she is British.
But in this film, she plays a woman from India.
Yes, it's interesting how they did her makeup.
Yes.
I think she might be up for an award, the makeup person that did her makeup.
Yes, they had no makeup, which was totally shocking. Very effective. It's like the audience had to use their imaginations. There was no set, no costumes, nothing. Just people. Mad people doing stand-up comedy.
Yes, it was very interesting.
Let's see this scene. This scene is a scene that happened outside of here, Sam.
Yes, yes.
Nurse Ratched, I'm getting no restraint here.
First of all, the Punjabi woman with the beer.
Walking.
Oh! I don't
do know that because he told me when we were in Paris for the weekend. I didn't really appreciate finding out that you'd already been with him.
You went to Paris with Christopher Walken?
I don't want to talk about it.
All right, fine. This film is about going out 5 nights with Christopher Walken. There's a different woman every night, okay? Christopher Walken gets inebriated 3 out of 5 nights. Guess what happens the other 2 nights? He murders these women. Now, it's a very compelling film. Oddly, it was a musical.
And reality film.
It was done in a documentary style, with spontaneous singing. And then, you know, Christopher Walken can't stop dancing, for God's sake. How old is he? 75.
I mean.
All right, let's look at a clip.
All right, this is where they're dancing.
All right.
Raw form.
Oh no, my daughter has fainted. I better call the doctor.
Ring, 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 ring.
Hello?
Doctor, come quickly. My daughter has fainted.
I'll be right there.
Doctor, doctor, my daughter has fainted.
She is dead.
Same! So much to work with, am I right? What I need from you now is a genre that you'd like to see this play in.
Opera.
Documentary.
I heard opera.
Opera. Documentary.
Well, maybe do that next time.
Boom! Boom! Boom!
Hello? Hello?
It seems that life out here in the toy soldier land isn't all I hoped it out to be. Maybe have a cup of tea. Ow! Oh, no! Come on! I wonder if the phone will let me ring again. Hello? Is anybody there?
Operator.
Oh, hello, operator.
About time.
This is Mr. Simmons.
How can I help you, Mr. Simmons?
Did someone call
you
before?
Yes, the doctor.
Oh, who is this?
Yeah, hey, my son fell off the ladder.
Oh,
are you coming?
Well, why would I do that?
Because you're supposed to get him back ready. He's got to get ready to help me fix the ladder.
Oh, this time writing, I completely forgot that I was a doctor.
Yes,
be right back.
Jeez, you can't get good help my tricycle.
Hello, Mrs. McNally. Hello, Barbara John.
He's taking
a problem down the street.
Time. You know. Hello?
Jeez, I'm riding all around town trying to find this.
Oh, here we are. Okay, here he is. See?
Oh,
look, he keeps trying to get up, and I keep telling him to get better.
All right, listen.
Where is he?
What seems to be the problem?
It's my mother keeps knocking me over.
Dramatic telenovela in an alien language.
Baby, 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 baby
Commissioner, like anybody can get that out. Just call me Liz. I am an entrepreneur, besides being an actor. That's a French word, by the way. So, besides being up here being crazy, I'm actually a voiceover talent. I record in both English and French for clients all over the world. Now, when I mean French, okay, je veux pas dire cette putain de merde de français qu'on essaie de faire passer par Google Translate. Non, moi je veux dire du vrai français, du beau français, du français qu'on parle en France, du français qu'on parle avec nos frères et nos sœurs au Canada, hein? I mean, really, can you believe it?
Oui, oui, oui!
So, as an entrepreneur, very often people ask me this. How do you do it? They say it with that face. How do you do it? Well, tonight, we're going to give you the opportunity to get advice for free, in English though, okay? And get advice that will help you in your daily life. So I'd like to present to you the good, the bad, and the ugly advice. Because of course, advice is not always black and white, especially when you're getting it from an improv troupe. So, who would like some advice on anything, anything at all? Let us know. What would you like some advice on?
How can I stop flatulence?
How can, very good question. How can you stop flatulence? Trista.
I recommend a very good fibrous diet. Carrots, Brussels sprouts are my favorite. And of course, you don't want to forget the Metamucil.
There's no reason to call it flatulence. We know you're saying fart. Just first be open about it. It's nothing proper. Then I recommend a good cork.
I don't think you got a problem at all.
Wonderful, thank you so much. Anybody else would like some advice?
How to raise a child.
I'm sorry?
How to raise a child.
How to raise a child. How does one raise a child?
You know, it takes a village to raise a child. So you want to surround yourself with people who love and people who have positive outlooks on life. And you need really good education.
First, you gotta get a child. Now you can find them at the supermarket. But usually their mothers are nearby. So, school bus stops are good. They're never there. They're just there in the morning. Other places I can recommend are like your friends' kids. Chances are most your friends are exhausted from being parents and they'll just hand them over. And then once you get them, you know, get a television.
Two words, alcohol, Prozac.
What should you get your husband for Christmas?
There are so many wonderful choices, aren't there? You can go with things that are sports related. You can go with things that are fitness related. I think that I just love the things available at Hammacher Schlemmer.
I get him like a full body massage. Men love just massages. By like, you know, really strong women. Strong, angry women. Just wanna like, guy, guy! Massage your husband!
Just get him a mistress.
Anyone else?
How to get away with murder.
How to get away with murder.
Murder is that there's always a body. So I'm going to tell you that there are a lot of wonderful things that you can do by searching on the internet. YouTube has some wonderful, wonderful videos. I also heard that pigs will eat the body. So you need to know in advance murder someone before you've decided what to do when you're done. It really is about planning.
This is what I did, okay? It's really easy. You get a hat, and you get, like, one of those things that goes like that, you're talking louder, that thing, a megaphone, and you tell everyone you're a tour guide. Then you pick, like, something really weird nobody wants to get a tour of. But maybe like one person. Like you could say you're running a special Halloween tour for people who like to count cracks in the street. And chances are you're probably gonna get like maybe nobody. But like if you get one and you're walking down the street with them, then you just take them into an alley and you say, this is where we rest. And then you give them drugs. Usually like a shot in the butt will do it fast. Because most people wear cloth pants. No one wears armor anymore. So you get them in the butt, and then what you do is really easy actually. You just put them in the garbage. And then like you go get your nails done.
The only real way to get away with murder is to turn it inward.
We have some experience here. Anything else you'd like some advice on?
Incontinence.
I'm sorry?
Incontinence.
Right.
That goes with thought.
Yeah.
That's for another question. That's gross.
I'm thrilled. I follow direction. Let's ask for another question.
Sell your house.
Selling a house.
The house to sell.
Let's go with selling a house.
Yes, preparing a house to sell is a very arduous task. What I recommend that you start with is find a realtor that you really trust. If you're not sure who to go to, ask your friends on Facebook. I'm sure they all know a realtor. Once you find a good realtor, bring them through your house. Make sure you've cleaned it first. I promise they will still find a laundry list of things for you to fix before you can put it on the market. Once the realtor has been through, now invite your mother. She will then find all the other things that you want to put. And you want to put those things on the list as well. I recommend, if you are a couple, that you work as a team, because this will only get done well if you work together.
First-time homeowner mortgages are really common, so you try to find, you know, one of those people, because they don't know anything about real estate. And generally, people like that are in their 20s and early 30s, so what you do is you spice it up a little bit. You know, you got to be with the times. You got to make things saucy and sassy, and people think something's original. So what you do is you haunt your house. Now, luckily, we live near Woodstock, so there's a lot of people who will help you. You can do, like, spider webs you can get in the store. You can dress up and be an old lady in a rocking chair in a closet. That's scary. You can get, like, a man standing in, like, a tuxedo covered in dust standing at the top of the stairs. Just tell him don't say anything. That's scary. Other things that are scary, oh, like the pipes bursting. Just disconnect them under the sink. And then right when they walk in, just, like, have someone turn it on downstairs in the basement. And make sure you have a lot of switch panel thing in the basement, because then you can flick all the lights on. And then you'll get, like, you know, one of those 25-year-old kids who's like, whoa, this is cool, I'm gothic.
I don't even know what the hell we're talking about. Just get yourself a mobile home or something.
And that will be that. Thank you so much.
Tonight, we will have experts on everything. We have experts on belly button lint. We have experts on foreign ballroom dancing.
We have experts on witchcraft, experts on cooking of all different kinds, expert in yawning, experts in everything. I want to know from you, what kind of experts would you like to see tonight on our show? An expert in what?
Yoga.
Yoga expert. We'd like to see a yoga. What else?
Slinky.
Yawning. What?
Slinky.
A slinky expert.
Pumpkin
yell him out.
Carver.
What? Pumpkin carving expert. Yes.
Donald Trump.
Donald Trump expert or Donald Trump himself?
No, expert.
Expert. The expert on Donald Trump. What else?
Turning on lights.
What?
Monty Python.
Monty Python expert. What else?
Turning on lights.
Turning on lights? Turning on lights expert. Come on now, storm out. Keep going.
Sweeping. Yeah.
Huh?
Sweeping.
Sweeping.
Dog fleas.
Dog fleas.
Yodeling.
Yodeling. Yodeling. An expert on yodeling. They're not there yet.
Journalism.
Journalism. An expert on journalism.
Mysticism.
Hurdles?
Hurdles.
Turtles. An expert on turtles.
Middle
Do we have our experts? Yeah. We have our experts. Round of applause for our guests. Come on down, Jones. Come down here with me. Thank you so much for coming to the show. What I'd like from each one of you is to give us your full name and your expertise.
Yes, my name is Knigget Windham. I am an expert on Monty Python.
An expert on Monty Python. Excellent. And our next one.
I'm Mildred Snowflake, and I'm an expert on dog fleas. Only the fleas.
Fabulous. Expert on fleas. And finally.
I'm Pete Stringy, and expert on slinkies.
So Monty Python, dog fleas, and slinkies. I'll just open it up to the audience. Put your hands up if you have a question for any of our experts. Anybody would like to ask a question of any of our experts? Oh, back there, I see a hand, yes.
How high can a flea jump?
How high can a flea jump is the question.
You know, that's a very good question, and I will tell you that no one knows. We've only been able to count the number of inches and feet in the light, but we know they go much higher in the dark. It's a mystery.
It's a mystery. Another question for another one of our experts. Slinkies or Monty Python? Yes, over here.
For the slinky person, what is your reaction to every set of stairs?
What's your reaction to every set of stairs?
Well, you gotta start at the top and just head right down. Alone, repaired.
Like this?
Just like a flinkety sound.
Good question. Yes, right here.
Just since we're already practicing, what is your favorite silly walk?
Ah, my favorite silly walk. I think, and I have to be careful because, you know, the last time I did, but my favorite actually is.
You can get yourself tangled doing that.
I'm getting really close to patenting that.
Very slow. Yes.
That's great. I can't do that. I'm 44. Any other questions for our experts? Yes,
favorite dog.
This is for everybody. Why did you become
The young lady would like to know why you became an expert in what you're an expert on.
Well, for me, it was a seminal moment when I saw Monty Python and the Holy Grail. I mean, you know, when I saw John Cleese there farting in my general direction, I knew he was doing it to me. I just knew. And that was just that.
Sorry.
Thank you. Yeah, so I just felt that John Cleese was just farting in my personal general direction.
That always gets me.
I remember getting pushed down the stairs when I was little. It took quite a tumble there for a while.
Can I make a confession?
Yes, please.
I wasn't planning on telling anyone this. I'm a hoarder. I can't get rid of the fleas. So I became an expert. But it hasn't helped. I'm just going to tell you that.
Does anybody here have a particular particular problem you're wrestling in your life that perhaps one of these people could solve? Yes.
My monkey is stuck in the dishwasher.
Your monkey is stuck in a dishwasher.
Well, have you gone to the place, you know, really, this is, are you sure that he's dead?
No, he's not.
He's not dead?
No.
Okay, see, I can't help you then because I only deal with dead parents, sorry.
Any other questions? Slinkies, I know there's so many questions on the tip of your tongue.
What do you do when the slinky gets stuck on the step?
Oh, that's a very good question. What do you do when the slinky's stuck?
Never quite come up before.
I guess it's a hypothetical.
The centrifugal force is really keeping them going. I mean, I don't think they've ever really stopped.
What kind of
Give
me an object.
Oh, a vagina tightener.
Sometimes you're sitting in your house alone. Sometimes you feel kind of sad. Sometimes you wish you had a little something else that would make you feel glad. It's called vagina tighteners. Vagina tighteners. Everybody needs one. Everybody does.
And when you find the right brand, because you know you can't just use any one tan, because he can't use one, she can though. Does she have one that she likes?
It saved my marriage.
Everyone,
vagina tighteners, vagina tighteners.
Everybody needs one. Yes, they do.
Call 1-800 type vagina today.
That's no cone.
By the knees of Benjamin.
Soup on a stick.
Soup on a stick! Usually I take the first one, but I thought, hell, it's a long one. Okay, go ahead, guys.
We here at the Soup Lover's Kitchen, we are always looking for innovative ways to bring you new products.
Hey, Mom, what's for dinner?
Oh, well, tonight, son, we're having soup.
Honey,
that
looks
really
good.
But
I gotta get to the game. I need something on the go.
I know. Here's one. Soup on a stick. We've got clam chowder. We've got vegetable soup. We have chicorita.
Oh, chicorita, my favorite.
What do you think, son?
This will be great. I won't get my ass kicked at all.
Soup on a stick, vegetable chop by today.
T-shirts?
Plastic.
Plastic t-shirts. Oh, God. Janet, I'm so tired of working out all the time and never losing any weight.
You know this problem with your clothes being too absorbent? What you need are the new plastic t-shirts. What they do is they hold in the sweat so you become like your own microwave oven. Put on the plastic t-shirt and just watch the pounds float away.
You're looking gorgeous.
I feel you have.
I feel like I'm going to be sick.
I used to weigh 475,000 pounds.
Side effects may include spontaneous combustion, anal leakage, minor fainting, sweaty socks.
Plastic t-shirts.
Plastic t-shirts, everyone.
Thank you.
how to speak up and try to make something up.
Oh, really? Come back. In fact, so where are they from?
What's the town?
Belwood. I'm going to say, if I, there it comes up again, I transfer these things from Belwood, PA, which is like you made. All right.
Thank you.
is not.
I didn't touch it, so I'm not sure what's going on.